Father, we cover this world with the blood of Jesus. Every ears and heart and mind that we protect over this world, we cover them all with the blood of Jesus. The blessings that accompany this world, we cover them with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the living God. Our God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
Our God is good.
The title of our message today is The Battle is the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
The title of our message today is The Battle is the Lord. The battle of your life that you have been engaged with, perhaps for a series of years or decades, I want you to realize that you cannot fight that battle. But this battle is the battle of the Most High God. No matter the tension in that battle, no matter all you have lost in that battle, no matter all you are going to meet in this battle in the future, I want you to realize one thing alone, that this battle is of the Most High God.
Amen.
And if this battle is of the Lord, I'm now encouraging you, don't give up. Continue to the very end. Praise the living God.
Amen.
If you don't mind that you are having your scripture, please turn with me to the book of 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel chapter 17, I'm reading from verse 47, and it says, "And all this assembly shall know that the Lord saveth not with sword and spear, for the battle is the Lord's, and he will give you into my hands." Praise the living God.
Amen.
When David was facing a similar situation that we are facing today, and which I'm facing as well, when the entire nation of God was being humiliated by a single man. But when the anointing of the Holy Spirit comes upon David, and David withstood that man with the power of the Holy Spirit, and he said, "This battle is of the Lord. Today it shall be declared openly that the Most High God, there is no power that can ever beat him." Praise the living God.
Amen.
And under that anointing, David was able to overcome an enemy of the entire nation. Praise the living God.
Amen.
What have been your problem or what you have been struggling with for years? I don't know. But I know one thing for sure. When you are in this living God, who has made heaven and the earth, who owns all powers and authority, victory is yours in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
If you don't mind, let us go to the book of Psalm chapter 60 to confirm the ability of this God. Psalm chapter 60, I'm reading from verse 11. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
And it says, "Give us help from trouble, for then is the help of man." Praise the living God.
Amen.
When you realize that then is the help of any man or any woman that will be on your side, if you realize what David realized, you will start calling upon the living God, who will give you help from any trouble that you are facing or you are passing through. No matter the high rate of that trouble, no matter the tensions, no matter the predicaments, no matter how many enemies that you have been facing as a threat in your life, when you realize what David realized, I believe you will pray like David. When David realized that there is no help from any man, there is no help from any power, except from the living God. And he said, "Oh Lord, who has made heaven and the earth, the waters and all that is in them, give us help in this situation. For in vain is the help of any man, in vain is the help of any power. There is no power that can give you victory in what you are passing through, except the power of the Most High God." Praise the living God.
Yeah.
What you might have been passing through might have come from this land, or from where you are coming from to this place, or anywhere from this world. But remember what the scripture says in the first place in the book of Revelation chapter 12. And it says, "Woe unto the earth and the inhabitants of this earth, because devil has come down upon this earth to dominate the people of God." Praise the living God.
Yeah.
And when you understand that your trouble and sorrows are coming from that enemy that is being called Satan, the old serpent, you have to realize the only power that can overcome this power is the living God. I'm encouraging you today to come unto that living God, whom David went unto him, and then he started to claim victory over all his enemies In all the battles that he went into, he was successful and he conquered all those battles. Praise the living God. Amen. Remember in verse 9 of Psalm chapter 60, David said, "Who will lead me into this battle? Who will lead me into this strong city? Is it not you, O Lord?" Praise the living God. Amen. I want you to realize the powers in God. Coming closer to God will help you to overcome what you are passing through. Advice from any man or from any woman, power from other sources can never help you to overcome through what you are fighting. Understand that this battle is of the Lord. It's of no man or any woman. Let us continue if you don't mind. Open with me to the book of Joel the prophet chapter 2. I'm reading from verse 32. And it says, "And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be delivered." Praise the living God.
Amen.
And the Lord keeps speaking through prophet Joel, and he says, "And it shall come to pass in a day like this and in a situation like this, perhaps in your homeland, perhaps in a foreign land, that anybody that calls upon this living God, that person shall be delivered. And that person can overcome his tensions and fears, which he has been passing through." Praise the living God.
Yeah.
It might have been a long time problem, but no matter how long it is, no matter how powerful those problems might be, no matter how strong your opponents or your adversaries might be, I want you to understand one thing. All power comes from the Most High God. It is high time for you to commit this battle into the hands of God. As all the people of God did in the days of old, all of the true children of God that commit their battle in the hands of God, and God came and fought that battle, and victory was theirs. I would like you today to claim victory in the name of the Most High God. When you give this battle unto the hands of the Most High God, praise the living God.
Amen.
We are a message of hope. I want you to understand the children of God are people of hope. The children of God are not known with hopelessness. We are not known with humility. No power that can humiliate you in any situation or circumstances. When you know the God that you are worshiping and the God that you are following, praise the living God.
Amen.
Coming to our Bible test, if you don't mind, please. Turn with me to the book of Isaiah the prophet. Isaiah chapter 37. I'm reading from verse 1. And verse 1 says, "And it came to pass, when King Hezekiah had it, that he rent his clothes, and covered himself with sackcloth, and went into the house of the Lord." Praise the living God.
Amen.
When a popular king in their generation, the king of Assyria, when he has conquered all the neighboring nations surrounding them, and left Israel alone, he has not conquered, he decided to engage the people of God in battle. I want you to understand the theme of our message today from this book of Isaiah 37. This arrogant king has conquered all the nations surrounding them, and he decided now to go into the people of God. Perhaps the land of Israel was one of the smallest among the lands within his territory in those days. But he never knew that the power that is in that land is greater than the power of heaven and earth. And that same power is the power in you. As a child of God, who is following God, who is worshiping God sincerely, the power in you is the power that has made heaven and earth. And when this king sent forth his message to the people of Israel, and he said, "I will destroy Israel and all the land of the people of God." Praise and thank God.
Amen.
When the king Hezekiah heard the warning of this man, he went into the house of the living God. I want to let you understand why it is important to go to the living God. He did not sit back in his palace. He did not sit back in his home. But he went right into the presence of the Most High God. And he put down his clothes. And he put on sackcloth. And he starts calling upon that God who has made heaven and the earth to come and intervene. Because the battle is of the Lord. No man can fight that battle in that generation. They acknowledge the power and the splendor of that king of Assyria. Praise the living God.
Yeah.
For you in your life and in your time, I'm encouraging you as a child of God. That battle, bring it to the living God.
Yeah.
There is no need of spending money unnecessarily. calling people that you are even better than spiritually to come and assist. Remember what the scripture says. Cause unto them that put their trust in men. Any man or woman that puts his trust in any man, that this man will be the solution of this battle. And the Lord says, cause be unto such a person. Praise and give God.
Amen.
And in the book of Isaiah, chapter 48, and the Lord keep on cautioning I and you. Don't go to other gods that are no gods. The gods that our forefathers worshipped and they ended up dying in the desert. And he said, don't go to those gods. And even if you are going to those gods, letting God come out and compete with those gods for you to know the reliable power. Praise the living God.
Amen.
As a child of God, it is high time for you to come unto the living God with prayers. Hezekiah went into the temple of the Most High God without consulting any priest, without consulting any prophet, without consulting any magician. But he went into the presence of the living God and he called unto him and he said, Father, come. This battle is of yours. We have no power to withstand such a great and mighty king, but you have power to withstand him. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And let us proceed. If you don't mind, verse 33 of Isaiah chapter 37. And verse 33 says, therefore, thus said the Lord, concerning the king of Assyria, he shall not come into this city, nor shoot an arrow there, nor come before it with shields, nor cast a band against it. Praise the living God.
Amen.
When the Lord God heard the cry of Hezekiah, and he sent his servant Isaiah, and he said, thus says the living God, in that situation you are passing through, panicking, that this king of Assyria, no matter his mightiness, no matter his strength, no matter his large army, that the Most High God has spoken, that this man will never come into this land. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And he says, not of the arrows of this man that will ever land in this land, because the Most High God is protecting this land. For he shall surely fight this battle and put him to shame. And in your case and in your situation, the same will happen.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
When you bring this battle to the Most High God, who can fight that battle?
Yeah.
Is it battle of sickness? Don't spend your money anymore.
Amen.
It is time to come upon God, who can fight that battle and cast it away out of your life.
Amen.
Is it the battle of disappointments and failures? Praise the living God.
Amen.
It is not the portion of the people of God.
Amen.
Because the Most High God have purchased you by the Son, by the blood of his Son, Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
And since you are of God, God will come into that battle.
Amen.
What is debarring God from fighting for us is sin. If we can only diligently listen to our living God, do your best. I'm not saying you should be righteous, but if it is possible for you to be righteous, be righteous.
Mm-hmm.
And call upon this living God, as Hezekiah called upon this God. And verse 34 says, by the way that he came, by the same shall he return, and shall not come into this city, said the living God. Praise the living God.
Yeah.
This is impossible. As a man to believe that a man who has come with his large army, that from their camp, from their front line, they will not enter into the city that they are seeing. Praise the living God.
Yeah.
I want you to understand following God and the word of God and the power that accompanies the word of the Most High God. How God will do this and bring it to manifestation, you don't know.
Yeah.
It is not your duty to know,
mm-hmm.
and you don't need to ask. Mm-hmm. But whatsoever, the only thing you need to do is to keep on talking to God, to come into this situation.
Amen.
And when Hezekiah called unto God, and God says, from the camp of this man called the king of Assyria, he shall return from the same way that he came.
Mm-hmm.
That he will never step into this land that he sees.
Mm-hmm.
None of his arrows or weapon will ever drop in this land.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
I told you last week, there are angels of God that are performing miracles in the life of people. They are the power protecting land. They are the power destroying land. And once this angel comes in your life, you don't need to panic. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And let's continue with verse 35. Verse 35 says, for I will defend this city to save it from my own sake and for my servant David's sake. Praise the living God. The Lord is deciding to do something in your life for his own sake, for his name, for enemies not to criticize the name of the Most High God, for his name to be glorified. And he said, I will do this for my own sake and for the sake of the covenant I'm having with your father David. Praise the living God. At the end, we shall come to conclusions, understand if this man succeeded in coming into the land of the people of God or not. Praise the living God. Amen. If you don't mind, let us continue with our message. Come with me to the book of Numbers. Numbers chapter 22. Numbers chapter 22. I'm reading from verse 37. Amen?
Amen.
If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
And he says, and when the ass saw the angel of the Lord, she fell down under Balaam, and Balaam's anger was kindled, and he smote the ass with a staff. 28. And the Lord opened the mouth of the ass, and she said unto Balaam, what have I done unto thee, that thou hast smiting me these three times? Praise the living God.
Amen.
I'm telling you about the angels of God that will fight that battle for you when the hour comes. And in the case of the people of God, remember when the children of God were climbing out of the land of Egypt, and they came to a place where they encamped, and a man they called Barak decided to destroy the people of God. I want you to understand how God is fighting this battle for you. And the children of God, they never knew that people have conspired against them. They were camping, and they were conspiring on how to destroy them. But the Most High God, who will fight that battle, he knows ever before this battle starts and before this conspiracy. And he sent forth his angel. When the man convinced a man called Barak to come and curse the people of God, for the people of God to die. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And this powerful angel went and withstood this ass and Barak, who was going to curse the people of God. And an ass keep on seeing vision. Praise the living God.
Amen.
The ass that he was using was seeing vision. He was seeing this angel of God. And angel of God keep on intercepting them from that journey, that they will not make that journey against the people of the Most High God. And the prophet was not even seeing anything. I want you to understand the power of God. When the battle comes in your life, how many battles that God has been fighting, you don't know.
Yeah.
How many more battles that God will fight in your life, you don't even know.
Amen.
When you are asleep, God is fighting for you.
Yeah.
These angels keep on fighting on behalf of the children of God. And verse 31 says, then the Lord opened the eyes of Balaam, and he saw the angel of the Lord standing in the way, and his sword drawn in his hand, and he bowed down his head and fell flat on his face. Praise the living God.
Amen.
This angel of God are the people that will fight the battle of your life. Praise the living God.
Amen.
When the hour, when the time comes, no matter the rate of that battle in your life, no matter how many enemies that have risen up against you, no matter how long that problem has taken in your life, call upon the living God to come and fight that battle.
Amen.
And these heavenly angels will descend to come and surprise you. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And when the children of God were there encamping, praying unto their living God, an enemy was on his own way, keep on cursing the people of God, inviting those that will come and curse them so that they will die. Let me tell you one thing. No matter the threats that they have been threatening your destiny, your life, give it unto the living God.
Yes.
Because these powerful angels of the Most High God are those that will fight this battle.
Amen.
This battle is of the Most High God.
Amen.
No man, no woman can ever defeat a child of God.
Amen.
The people of God are undefeated people. No power that will ever defeat them. No matter the shrines that they have consulted, or the gods or goddess of this land or of this world that they have consulted against you, they shall never prosper. According to the book of Isaiah, chapter 54, verse 17, that says, that no weapon of the enemies form against a child of God that shall ever prosper. Praise the living God.
Amen.
When you realize this, I want you to come to the living God.
Yeah.
I want you to bring that battle to the living God.
Yeah.
At least you have struggled for so many years.
Yeah.
And all your struggle has been in vain. Because you don't have that power. Because what the scripture says is this. In the book of Zechariah chapter 4 verse 6. He says, not by power and not by might. But by the spirit of the living God. Praise the living God.
Amen.
There is no need for us to continue following God faithlessly. No matter the weight of that problem. If you don't mind, let us continue with the same book of Isaiah 37. Isaiah 37 verse 36 and 37. And it says, then the angel of the Lord went forth and smote in the camp of the Assyrians 185,000. And when they arose early in the morning, behold, they were all dead corpses. Praise the living God.
Amen.
When the time of the battle comes, remember that King of Israel was panicking. He was crying. But the word of God came back to him repeatedly. Keep on telling him that you don't need to fight. You don't need to panic. Because I'm the one to fight. But he was confused. How will God fight this battle? The large army that he seen, pitching very close to him. How possible will this be? I want you to understand. Impossibility is for you and for me, but not for the living God.
Yeah.
What the scripture says in Matthew 19:26, it might be impossible with men, but with God, all things are
possible.
So how God will come in to do it in your life, I don't know. How God will come in to do it in my own life, I don't know. But we have to hope and continue following that God to the very end. Don't backslide from calling you a God because the expectation of what you need, you have not received it today or tomorrow. Continue with this living God. And when the children of God were there panicking, they never knew that God has arranged his special forces. I'm telling you, what happens spiritually, it comes from the power of the Most High God. What we are seeing in the manifestation of what God did comes down to the knowledge of man. But when it's happening, when it is taking place spiritually, you will not be aware of what God is doing. God has prepared the host of his heavenly powers, those that we fight that battle.
Amen.
And he commanded his children to have their peace. Because this battle is of the Most High God. And Hezekiah was there panicking. And God sent forth his angels. And a whole 185,000 soldiers were destroyed. Overnight, within a twinkle of an eye. Praise the living God.
Amen.
I want you to understand the power in God. Then the word of God that came earlier to Hezekiah and said, in verse 34 and 35, that he said, from that camp of that king of Syria, he shall return back to his homeland from that camp. And nobody believed the word of God. Hezekiah did not believe the word of God. And the people of Israel, I'm very sure they did not believe. Because they are seeing these people very close to them. But how God will do it, nobody knows. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And when the hour comes, the Lord went and did it. And verse 37 says, so Sennacherib, king of Assyria, departed and returned, and went at Nineveh. Praise the living God.
Amen.
When he rose in the morning, he realized that his army has been destroyed by the Most High God. He went back from the same way that he came. To give to the manifestation of the word of God. According to the scripture, it says, none of the word of God that shall come to pass. Instead, the word of God shall not come to fulfillment. The heavens and the earth shall pass away. Praise the living God.
Amen.
The God you are serving and worshiping is no man. It is not the idol of nations. It is not the gods of nations. It is not the goddess of nations. But it is the Most High God. Who has made heaven and the earth and every other power that you are seeing. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And verse 38 says, and it came to pass, as he was worshipping in the house of Nisroch, his God, that Adramalek and Sherezer, his sons, smote him with his sword, and they escaped into the land of Abania, and Esarhaddon, his son, ran in his stead. Praise and thank God.
Amen.
The Lord did not end up in destroying his army, but God continued to destroy him even unto his own land. And his sons finally killed him. Praise and thank God.
Amen.
The enemy of people of God, when your God comes into that battle, that enemy will run away.
Amen.
No matter the group and the most powerful occultic men that are chasing you, the Lord will allow you to understand that something is going on.
Yeah.
That there is conspiracy that they have gathered up against you. Is it the demons of your forefathers? Let me tell you, having double standing, it doesn't help. If you are standing on the Most High God, stand on the Most High God. If you don't want to stand on the Most High God, choose any way you feel like. But my advice to you is this: stand properly on the name of this Most High God. From the book of Genesis to the book of Revelation, all that stood upon the name of the Most High God, none of them was being put to shame. Praise the living God.
Amen.
According to that book of Joel 2:32, he says, to all that fall upon the living God shall be delivered.
Amen.
No matter the fear, no matter the power that is tormenting you, no matter what you are passing through, no matter what you are yet to pass through, just be assured that the living God will fight that battle and give victory and peace unto you. Yes. Praise the living God.
Amen.
If you don't mind, let us continue to the view of the apostles of Christ in such a situation. The book of Hebrews, chapter 6, verse 11, if you don't mind, turn with me to the book of Hebrews, chapter 6, verse 11. And he says, and we desire that every one of you do show the same diligence to the full assurance of hope unto end. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And when St. Paul was talking to the people of God, people that might have been passing the situation that I and you are passing through today in Romans, and he said unto them, it is good that you come unto this living God. Take stand in the living God. Have full hope in this living God. Have assurance in this living God. No matter the problem that you are having, it is time for you to give it unto the living God. Who can solve that problem for you? Every other power may solve their problem half and half. But when you bring it unto the living God to come and take control and care of that situation, he will solve it 100% right. Praise the living God.
Amen.
There is no problem that God has handled half and half before in the history of mankind to all the holy children of God that have existed in the past. I don't understand that most of our problem is stubbornness to the word of God, hopelessness in the word of God. When you are not having that faith, that hope, and assurance that God can do it, how do you think that God can do it? Devote much time for the worship of the Most High God. And tell God that which is your problem. Don't do it just a month. The second month, you go back home. Continue telling God what you need. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Among all the children of God that come unto the living God, one of them stopped. Mordecai, when he was in exile, he kept talking to that living God. When they have signed and decreed that he must surely die, I want you to understand the powers in prayers. When you are praying, talk to the living God whom you are not seeing. Don't believe you are anything before God. When you ask some people to pray, they feel reluctant. How do you think that God will know what is your problem? In that case of Mordecai, in his exile, he gathered all the children of God and he asked them, let us go into the powers of prayers and talk to the Most High God. When a man named God, Haman, decided to eliminate all the children of God, and the king has approved his demand to destroy the people of God, and when the time comes, they talk unto that living God within a twinkle of an eye, and the case was revised. And all of the child of God was killed. And Mordecai was protected as well. There is power in prayers.
Yeah.
When you understand the God that you are worshiping, When you stop worshiping other things that are not God, when you stop fooling yourself before the presence of God, some of us fool and mock yourself before the presence of God. The man that owns church is God Almighty. I told you last week. Blessings come from him. Curses come from him. Our arrogancy brings much problem for us, but we don't know. When I was doing a very nice job, I got angry from the presence of God one day. I left. And the next day they called me, they said, stop. I pleaded and cried all I could. No way. When you don't want to come and worship God, sit down in your house. If you know you cannot be submissive to God, who are you? What is man? What is man? You go out here and you collapse. Finish. They call us and everybody will come and celebrate and drink and go. I want you to understand. If you want to come to God, come to God sincerely. Humble yourself first. You are nothing. I don't see anybody else that will be anything before God. Myself, I'm nothing. The command of the angels of God, all of us may perish. If you realize it like that, some people told me make it like a club. If you people make it like a social club, I go to my house and sit down. What is the need for me to waste my time? Because I don't need anything like club. If I need club, I know where club is. If you want to go to club, you go to club and do whatever you feel like. If you want to worship God, you humble yourself first. Praise the living God.
Amen.
This is the end of our message. May God bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Please, if you can stand up for our prayers.